Actually, yan yung best time to learn how to budget habang nasa bahay ka pa. Because that would make you realize na, okay, since wala itong expenses ngayon, what if no, wala na ako sa bahay?
Hello mga ka-Arki! Hello! Kamusta?
Hello.
Ayan! Welcome
mga
back,
moments.
Adriel!
Yes, thank you for having me as a guest this weekend, no?
Ano ba? Hindi ka guest, no? Ano ka? Returning resident.
Returning resident.
So, mga ka-Arki, magandang araw sa inyo and welcome sa isa na namang pre-recorded video dito sa ating YouTube channel. Ayan. So, ang topic na pag-uusapan natin ngayon ay courtesy of Adriel. Ano ba yung topic natin?
Dahil marami tayong mga millennials, no, nanonood. So, yung topic natin ngayon ay ano yung mga financial things na gagawin natin in your 20s, no?
Nako, yung mga millennials ngayon, mga 30s na, no, mga Gen Z.
Oy,
na yan.
Millennial pa rin ako. Mga late millennials, no, yan. At Gen Z, yung mga ganyan.
Yun. Sige, so financial things to do during your 20s or basically when you're starting your career, no? So yun yung...
Di naman necessarily starting your career. So yung mga nandyan na sa mid-level or palapit na ng 30, no? So pwede pa rin. So may mga tips tayo within ages 20 to 29. Yan. Iba naman kapag 30 and above.
Ah, okay. So ano yun? Ibang video naman yun. Yung things to sina, do in your 30s.
Sina Marion na yan at sina Sir Renzi bahala dyan.
Oo. Kasi yun yung edad nila. O, anong first tip natin, Adriel?
Sige, first tip is to know how to budget, no? Lalo na yung mga in between 20 to 23 or 24 max, no? Because sila yung tipong nagkakaroon na ng sahod or first time nagkakaroon ng salary. So, mga first 2 months, happy pa yan dahil alam mo yun, first time magkaroon ng pera in their lives, hindi na galing allowance sa parents nila. So, after ng honeymoon phase, no, sa work, so, yun yung tamang panahon kung paano na magbabudget, no? Saan yung allocation ng sahod mo every month? Tapos ano yung pwede mong gawin for your first bonus, no? Or yung mga bonuses na paparating. So, yan yung first tip, knowing how to budget at ano yung expenses na kailangan natin i-prioritize.
Kahit na nakatira pa sila sa parents sila, kailangan...
Of course! Kailangan na malaman as early as possible. Na, no? Actually, yan yung best time to learn how to budget habang nasa bahay ka pa. Because that would make you realize na, okay, since wala itong expenses ngayon, what if no, wala na ako sa bahay? So, ano mangyayari? Diba? So that means money in that particular expense. Though it's easier kung wala ka sa bahay ng parents mo because that would allow you to learn faster. But for those staying at home, try to identify na yung mga future expenses in case you move out to your parents' home.
Mm-mm-mm. So at least ano no, makikita rin nila kung can afford na silang umalis sa bahay at to live on their own. But of course, pagdating sa pagbabudget, maraming mga strategies on how to budget. And it's important to for us to say na there's no best budgeting strategy. Maraming iba't ibang way para mag-budget. Hanapin nila kung saan sila magiging comfortable or ano yung mag-work dun sa lifestyle nila. Kasi yung iba, mayroong apps. Ako, naka-Excel lang ako. Yung iba, nag-envelope method. So, iba-iba siyang budgeting strategy.
Yes. Yeah. So, after so, learning yes, after learning how to budget, yung next step is getting your first insurance policy. Either term, most likely term, no? Pero kung medyo maluwag-luwag, pwedeng VUL, but most likely term. No, bakit term? Kadalasan ng term insurance pwedeng convertible to VUL. That's one. No, habang maliit pa yung sahod. Maliit kasi yung sahod basta starting eh. So term muna. After another reason for getting term insurance is that mataas yung coverage, no? So that means if in case may mangyari sa'yo, no? So yan naman yung purpose ng insurance protection, no? Highlight natin yan because kadalasan nakakalimutan yung protection part.
Kahit
sa insurance.
Kahit na wala kang financial dependence, kukuha ka ng life insurance?
The earlier you can buy, the better. Because you don't know kapag mag-develop kayo ng, alam mo yung morbidities, no? Or mga mm-hmm. future illnesses, no? Lalo na may COVID ngayon. So it's doubly important. Actually, may mga friends ako ngayon nakukuha ng COVID. Tapos apparently, that's actually additional rate kapag nakukuha ka ng life insurance. So that comes into play already, no? So as much as possible, get your term. Wag muna VUL because when you convert naman to a VUL, hindi nila titingnan yung history mo after 2 years. Part yan sa perks. As so, long as same coverage. No?
So basically, you're preparing for the future na kung meron kang balak mag-asawa, so syempre, magkakaanak ka and probably you'll have financial dependence in the future. So, kung kaya naman ng budget, you can get your life insurance as early para mura, no? But I would say na unahin yung emergency fund muna before yung insurance.
Yeah. Oo, but of course, part yan sa budgeting, no? Yung pagkuha ng emergency fund. But in case na medyo gipit tayo sa budget, we can opt for a funeral plan or a pre-need funeral plan. No? Yan yung lowest form of insurance or if not, yung mga micro-insurance, no?
Alright, so next tip, Adriel?
Yes, third tip would be knowing your investments. So that means studying kung ano yung mutual funds, UITF, crypto, forex, business, or whatever investment man yan, no? So bakit kailangan natin aralin to? This would make planning your goals and setting your goals easier, which we have a video on that, no? Yung how to make a simple financial plan. Because apparently, studies show that mayroon tayo magkaroon ng goal setting if we don't know ano yung goal natin at ano yung kailangan natin gawin to get to that goal. So to make life easier, alamin muna natin kung ano yung investments dahil yan yung vehicle natin, no? So alamin natin kung to get to that goal, kailangan natin ng bus, kailangan natin ng car, kailangan natin ng plane. So ito yung mga iba't ibang investments out there. So during your free time, read and watch videos about the different types of investments so that you'll be aware kung ano yung risk, no, associated to it. And that would also give you an idea kung ano yung risk appetite mo.
Mm-hmm. Sabi nga nila, di ba, the best investment is an investment in knowledge. So, ano?
And knowledge kahit, applied.
Yes. Of course, no? Education is useless without application. So, ang nakuha ko doon is kahit na hindi pa kaya ng budget nila talaga na mag-invest, pwede na silang mag-aral para pag lumalaki na yung sahod nila, they have more money and they now have funds for investment. Hindi na nila kailangan mag-aral kasi alam na nila yung mga investment. And of course, sabi nga natin, 'di ba? You cannot hit a target that you cannot see, or kung wala kang destination, magpapalaboy-laboy ka lang, no? So it's important to have financial goals so that you have a target or you have your particular destination so that you can properly choose the right investment vehicle na magdadala sa'yo dun sa destination mo or dun sa financial goal mo. So pag sinabi nating investment, investing in knowledge. So, ang mga basics na pag-aaralan nila is yung mga nabanggit mo, how does the stock market work, mutual fund, bonds, and lalo na ngayon, marami na rin mga resources on cryptocurrencies. And ano pa ba yung mga hindi ko nabanggit?
Forex, no?
Forex, becoming currency a bit market.
Hot. Entrepreneurship, it's becoming more and more trending, lalo na yung digital businesses, no, online businesses. So yun. What else? Dropshipping, no, common here in Singapore. Maraming ads on dropshipping here in Singapore. Oh. So maraming so types of businesses,
no. Yung yes, foundational knowledge on running a business on entrepreneurship. Kasi may mga kilala ako na gustong magnegosyo and ang alam lang nila is ang negosyo ay nagtitinda ka. Pero it's really more than that. And there's really an entrepreneurial mindset na kailangan mo to be able to succeed in business. So, yung mga yan, matututunan natin yan sa pagbabasa ng mga libro, panunood ng mga YouTube videos. Actually, marami akong YouTube videos na napapanood about entrepreneurship. And recently, sa Pilipinas, nauso din yung podcasting. So, pwede nila i-check yung mga nasa business category ng mga podcast platforms. And yun, makinig sila doon, lalo na kapag gumagawa sila ng mga household chores or nagda-drive. Marami akong kilala habang busy sa mga mechanical things na ginagawa nila, mechanical chores. They listen to podcasts kasi ano, it's very informative. And yun nga, you don't need your full attention sa kanila. Kailangan nakikinig ka lang sa kanila. So yun. Alright. Do you have more tips?
So, number four. Guys, number four. Very important to, no? So, bubulong ako sa inyo. Sige, ready na? Ready? Sige. Learn how to invest in yourself. Narinig yung bayan? So, yan yung tip number four. Yes.
Okay. What does that mean?
Why is that very important, no? Learning how to invest in yourself will open up more opportunities for you financially in the future, wherever they might be. Because sometimes our hobbies, no? Because we're learning different skills, might become our second source of income when push comes to shove or when you feel, minsan kasi may mga inspiring moments na, oh, gusto kong gumawa nito o gusto kong i-start ito. But apparently, nung nalaman nila yan, parang, oh, may kulang ako nito. So, diba? So, that would force them to learn this skill. But if you're like learning something already na related to that, that would make the process easier and faster, no? So, for example, for me, when I was in Singapore, I was actually learning how to do some graphic design. And actually, I was part of a club na nagsusulat ako ng articles for them. And that led me to an internship here in Singapore, no? Because apparently, at the same time, they were looking for someone na marunong magsulat. So, since I matched our profile, so yun, nakuha ko yung internship ko, which was actually a higher pay than my previous job in the Philippines. Oh. So, that was like a very big blessing.
Alam
so
mo ang trabaho sa Pilipinas dati. Joke lang.
I think. Basta yun.
So, yeah, I agree. I completely agree. Kasi marami tayong mga soft skills na hindi talaga siya tinuturo sa school na they will be very useful when you're on the outside world, quote-unquote. So, ano tong mga soft skills na to? Yun nga, pagsusulat, interpersonal skills, how do you talk to people, how do you negotiate, di ba? Yung negotiating skills.
Yep.
And also, networking skills. How do you approach people if you're in a room with strangers? How do you make sure that you make the most out of the experience? Kasi I've always believed that opportunities are always connected to people. So investing in yourself can also mean investing in your social network. So we go out, we meet people, we try to expand yung mga list of people that we know kasi sometime in the future, we might be able to use yung mga lessons or yung mga bagay na matututunan natin sa kanila kasi there's always something that you can learn from someone. Para sa akin, that's one of my beliefs.
Yeah, and this is important lalo na sa kay age ko, mid-20s to almost late 20s because ito yung mga taong na magle-level up na to managerial or mid-management level. So if you're moving to one company to another, importante yung negotiation, yung interpersonal networking. At the same time, what value you can bring to the company that you're applying to. No.
Mm-hmm. Maski public speaking skills, no? Kasi syempre, hindi ka man public speaker, but you would present reports to your boss, di ba? If you're if you become a manager, di ba, you would have to give your staff mga pep talk, di ba, mga once in a while you would have to talk to them. So yung speaking skills would also be very important. And as I've mentioned, these are skills that you don't really learn directly from your subjects in school. So there's a need to have the initiative to learn these.
Mm-mm. Yes. So actually yun yung four tips, but before we end, may isa pang bonus tip, no. So sa taong na nagsabi naghahanap ng adulting 102 video, treat this as your adulting 102 video, no. So sa mga ka-age ko or sa mga 20s, learn how to master OneCraft. Learn how to master one craft or one expertise, no? Be an expert on something. What I've learned actually for the past 12 months or I guess for the past year, now if you learn at least one thing and you do it very well, the opportunities becomes endless because people would look up to you. And at the same time, the income opportunities then would actually scale. This is actually a matter of scalability, no? Iba kasi kapag expert ka sa isang field versus someone na palipat-lipat, because as much as being a novice is very like exciting, you learn something new, but parang you're going back to like square one. So it's better to be in a progressive stage rather than going back, no? But after you master one thing, there's nothing wrong with like expanding your knowledge with other skills or topics or other expertise. But you always should have that one thing you should be good at.
Mm-hmm. So I totally agree. And ang approach ko dyan, usually when I do career orientation talks is you have to be curious. So try different things. Tapos when something appeals to you, try to have a mindset na magpo-focus ka doon. So you try to learn more about a specific thing na nag-spark ng curiosity mo. And then try to go deeper. Kasi people are always saying na follow your passion, di ba? Tapos find your purpose. And it's hard to find your passion or to follow your purpose outright. Kasi ang first step talaga doon is yung curiosity, trying things out, and then listening to yourself kung ano yung mag titrigger nung interest mo. And then once you find that particular interest that you like, the only way to nurture yung passion and yung purpose is to go deeper in that subject, which means yun nga sinabi mo, honing your craft, trying to be excellent in that field. Kasi dun mo madidiscover na, oo nga, this is something that is already beyond what most people know and I am enjoying it. And by that, you have already found, sabihin na natin, yung passion or one of your deep passions in life. So yun, napakagandang tip nun, bonus tip natin, Adriel.
Yes. So that's it, no, mga ka-Arki, for this today's session or today's video. So if you enjoyed it and if you learned something, please give it a thumbs up and smash that notification bell so that you won't miss a thing.
Yes, and of course, please remember to subscribe to our channel. So maraming salamat, Adriel, sa pagsama sa akin dito sa video na to. I hope maraming natutunan yung mga ka-Arki natin. So hanggang sa susunod ulit na video. Right? Thank you, Adriel.
Bye-bye, guys. Bye-bye. See you.